Without further ado, I would very much like to welcome Daniel to the stage. Let's.
Thank you very much, David. Thank you for inviting
Thanks.
us. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
All right, wonderful. And I also believe you can see my screen now, right? Can you maybe confirm that quickly, David?
Yep, that is confirmed.
Wonderful. Okay, so again, thank you very much for inviting me to this exciting event. Also, thank you to the plus 100 people that are taking an interest in digital health. I know many of you are university students, and also probably many are from the life science industry. So it's really a pleasure to be able to speak about our core passion, which is software within the life science industry. So I have approximately 10 minutes. I will try to be really quick through my slides, but there will of course be the chance to answer questions in the end. So there's one big problem in the world that we are all here to solve, and that is basically the healthcare challenge. So today, 95% of the world's population, they do have health problems, and 10% are affected by non-communicable diseases, so serious diseases. That can be, for example, cancer, it can be chronic kidney disease, it can be diabetes, and now we also see infectious diseases. So we really need to do something about that, and that's the reason why we have, you can say, the traditional healthcare industry. That can be life sciences, companies that produce medicine, medical devices, like we will hear from Coloplast in about 10 minutes, rehabilitation, treatments, and so forth. And where we see that digital health fits into this is really within each and every one of these separate industries in the healthcare, you can say, area. So what we do at Dawn Health is that we utilize a lot of different technologies, a lot of platforms and tech stacks to further enhance and improve and make more efficient the, you can say, the traditional healthcare services. So that's really how you should try and picture digital health. And I will, of course, give you a couple of examples. So what we really are at Dawn are specialists within digital health that are creating life-changing solutions. And we co-create and develop these innovative solutions together with the life science industry. These are specifically the customers that you see to the right. Novo Nordisk continues to be our biggest customer. But as a company that started in Denmark, we are now also extremely proud to have the likes of Pfizer and Johnson, that is Actelion down there in the bottom on this board, Takeda, AstraZeneca, Novartis, and so forth. So some of the really big, impressive tier one life sciences companies are now coming to us for us to support them in that digital journey. Just to put a little bit of figures to this, I don't want to talk too much finance, but this just goes to prove that the digital health industry is really accelerating. We've had organic hypergrowth from 2016 when all of this started. We are growing with 140% year by year from 16 to 21. We've become 45 people, three offices, three companies, one strategic spin-out called Exceed Health, 15 large customers, and we became Microsoft Partner of the Year for our endeavors with Novo Nordisk in 2021. So that's just a lot of stuff going on, and we like to say that we are just warming up. Because what you also know is that this little fellow here is all around us. And what we've seen with COVID-19 is, of course, a terrible situation for the world. But for digital health companies and for the life science industry at large, it is very much the dawn of a new industry. And that one is digital. So we really see that COVID-19 is propelling, accelerating, and advancing the ambition and the appetite for embedding digital interventions into normal treatments and enhancing patient outcomes. So the way we are structured as Dawn are, broadly speaking, in three separate pillars. With our global offices, you will find that same structure. We would like to be in all of the life science hubs around the world in approximately 3 years from now. Most of our projects, they start in the product strategy and design team. So here we have researchers and analysts, designers, people who are really good at product strategy, who are good at facilitating, that are co-creating and working together with life sciences to shape and form solutions to the biggest challenges that they face. At the same time, when we have a strong business case and a strong product roadmap ahead of us, when that is defined, We move the project to technology and operations. And here we have our tech leads that are producing our product, which is a medical device, but it's a medical device that is often a software. So this is within iOS, Android, web, backend, and you know, all of the usual, you can say, tech capabilities you would expect from a normal software company. And then on the very top, we have our subject matter experts. This can be medical doctors that are joining us in developing medical algorithms that can deliver new tools and solutions to patients. The whole quality part of developing software that are medical devices is extremely big, very important. And then, of course, the regulatory landscape, which is complex and one that we all need to really adhere to and, of course, have a lot of respect for. The backbone of our operation in the company, and where you also see that digital health is really shaping increasingly the industry, is our quality management system, the QMS. And now with MDR coming into play in the European Union and also strict requirements from the FDA in North America, companies will increasingly be required to have a certified quality management system. And here our notified body is British Standards Institute. So with them, we are now allowed to develop software on behalf of life sciences that is providing information that can be used for diagnostic or therapeutic purposes. So again, this is software that is also a medical device. So let's give you a couple of examples. I think for once I'm actually doing quite good on time. So maybe Mette will even have a couple of more minutes to speak. What you're looking at here is at least the portfolio that I'm allowed to demonstrate, and also some of the solutions that we've launched with Novo Nordisk, but only in region APAC. So region APAC is Asia Pacific. Novo Nordisk is divided into many different business regions. And this just goes to show that only in the Middle East and in Southeast Asia, we've been developing a lot of solutions together with Novo Nordisk that are working specifically within each of their therapeutic disease areas, driving improved patient outcomes, or delivering decision support services to medical doctors that are treating patients with type 2 diabetes, or for example, allowing parents who have children with growth hormone deficiency to diagnose that disease much earlier simply by taking a photo of the child. So that's a lot of stuff at play, and we really see not only Novo Nordisk, but the life science industry in general are really embracing and endorsing digital to drive their competitiveness, but of course always with the desire to do something more for the patient, right? So really drive that improved patient outcome. When we zoom out and we fly up in the helicopter, then from a global perspective, only with Novo Nordisk, so this is all of Novo, we are launching in more than 50 countries from 21 to 22. And that's also, again, a validation of digital health and what it can really do. So these are products that we've built together with Novo Nordisk. They are owned by Novo. They are governed by Novo Nordisk. They are developed by Dawn. But in all of these markets, we will now propel an innovation agenda that goes beyond the medicine. And that agenda is digital. So this is, of course, hugely exciting. And back to the discussion on data, what comes from this, what we get back, you can say on top of the improved patient outcomes and the transparency and the tools for the HCPs will of course also be a lot of knowledge and a lot of insight that can allow us to be even better in delivering healthcare services for the patients, for the people with chronic diseases that make a change. So the high castle of all of this and where we see many of the product and the project endeavors that we lift with life sciences, you know, the high castle and where everything is going is honestly speaking digital therapeutics. So this is an exciting space because you can launch consumer products and you can launch products that are not necessarily regulated as a medical device, simply to test and validate if there's appetite. But when you become more ambitious and you would like your intended use behind your product to do even more for the patients, that could be titrating insulin, for example, or it could be to give you critical information about how you are working and dealing with your ostomy, like we will hear in a second from Mette. Then we are moving into this space called digital therapeutics. So here you should picture software that is validated in clinical trials and that also has real world evidence. So it's documented that it works in the real world. These digital therapeutics can be completely standalone, so it's possibly only a software application for a person with schizophrenia. It can also be a complementary software solution working with a medical device or a medicine. That could be a product for example, Saxenda and Novo Nordisk, people with severe obesity. They have the medicine, now they also get the app, and that drives the improved patient outcome. Or it can be a combination where in the clinical trial, you are testing and you are validating both the medical device or the medicine together with the digital intervention. And the digital intervention is also part of your label when you go to the market. So that's the combination RX-DTX. This is super exciting stuff, and it's really fueling the innovation agenda in the life science industry. What I will end up with here is simply to say that approximately 3 days ago, McKinsey came out with an article saying that in the medical device industry alone, digital will accumulate to a $3 trillion value creation by 2030. And I know that Coloplast is doing quite a lot there. We have the pleasure of being part of that. So basically, I'll just hand it over to you, Mette, to take it forward. Thank you very much, guys.